सो प्रिवेंटिव एंड कंट्रोल मेजर्स, ओके, प्रिवेंटिव एंड कंट्रोल मेजर्स, नाउ व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट preventive and control measures means what we are going to study in this, we are going to study how can we prevent the attack of maybe bacteria, maybe fungus, maybe rodents, maybe different kind of insects, how can it be done. First which we have already discussed is drying just now. Okay, we have studied, I rubbed from there because there was no place to continue further. So what is drying? Just now we have studied also to allow the grains, okay, to to allow the grains to get rid of the moisture. But totally it can't be dry, the total seeds can't be made dry. Okay, as I told earlier also, the amount of moisture, okay, the amount of moisture in the seed should be 14% by its weight. Okay, so just now we have discussed the amount of moisture in the seed should be 14% by its weight. Okay, that means it should not be more than this. So we have discussed this thing also, that what farmers do, they spread the grains into the sun. Okay, and they use what? They use for spreading the seeds or the grains on the floor, they use plastic sheets or cemented, okay, floor. Why it should not be used, why it should not be spread on the surface directly? Because see, if grains are spreaded directly on the ground, so what will happen? First of all, the seeds are going to absorb the moisture from the seed will absorb moisture from the soil. Okay, and second, what will happen? Seeds will germinate. Seeds will germinate. Okay, this both the things will be very very disastrous. See, now what else are the things which should be done? Like when we have to prevent the crops, what has to be done? Second thing is cleaning. Okay, cleaning means which kind of cleaning? Like when I say cleaning, that means there should be no, that means there should not, like when the grains are stored, when the grains has to be stored, they need to be cleaned properly. That means there should not be like, you know, much amount of mud in that, lot of chaff suppose is left in that. So again it give rise to lots of chances for the insects to attack. Why, see, if the mud is there, mud or the grain or the soil particles are there, so automatically what will happen, along like in the soil microbes are there, water moisture is there, so again it is going to give chance for the insects or the bacteria and fungi to attack on the grains. So first of all, the cleaning, the place where the grains has to be stored, is it needs to be very very clean. Okay, the storing place, the place where the grains has to be stored should be very clean. Okay, why it has to be clean? Again, we all know a dirty place, again it give rise, if the place is dirty, it will be a pure invitation for the all kind of factors, like if we talk about all biotic factors, it will be pure an invitation to come and attack our grains. Okay, so the place should be totally clean. Now we have the place is very very clean. Okay, now the crops are there. Now what else which can be used is chemicals. Okay, so what is the meaning of chemicals? How chemicals? Spray of proper chemicals. Okay, spray of chemicals has to be done. Okay, the place where the crops has to be kept, before storing the grains only, the place should be cleared up, it should be clean. Okay, and before only a spray of chemicals should be done. Okay, why? Because see, when the grains are kept, after that some spray is done, okay, so it can be harmful, it can go inside the bags also. So what is the best way to spray the chemicals before the storage, before the grains has before the farmers keep the grains inside, a spray of chemicals is very very required, it is necessary, it is essential. Okay, now in this chemicals, one more thing I would like to talk about, which is fumigation. Now this can be a new thing for you, which is fumigation. Okay, what is the meaning of fumigation? Fumigation is a process in which the vapors of the chemicals are allowed to pass in the storeroom or in the godowns. Okay, wherever the grains are kept, there the fumigation is done. Okay, now what is fumigation? The vapors of the chemicals, okay, the vapors of the chemicals are passed in the storerooms. Okay, what is fumigation? These chemicals which are used for fumigation, okay, those chemicals which is used for fumigation can be solid, can be liquid. Okay, but when they are allowed to burn, or when they react with the moisture, okay, what happens, it is reacting, so what, it get converted into vapors. Okay, and when it gets converted into vapor, it gets spread all over easily in the rooms, in the storerooms. And this is very, very good method, strong way of keeping all the attackers away. Okay, so fumigation is a process which is done on a large scale nowadays. It is a very easy and effective method. At the same time, you know, effective it is, it need to be. The thing what is been done needs to be very, very effective. So this process is very, very effective. Fumigation is an effective process. Okay, now as I have discussed over here, sun drying method, you know, but many a times, like when we talk about drying of crops on the commercial level, on the very, very large scale, then the crops can be dried with the help of the artificial dryers, the electric dryers. Okay, so what can be used over here in place of sunlight? Again, what can be used here? I can write here electric dryers. Okay, electric dryers are used so that, see, if the electric dryers are used, it will be a very quick process, na? So and the moisture can also be removed easily. So this is also the process how the amount of water can be reduced from the grains. Now if we talk about certain things which you have seen at home, and how to prevent the grains, like see, many of us keep neem leaves, okay, neem leaves along with the grains. We all know neem prevents all these doesn't allow the rodents and insects to come. And so this is also one of the good method when it is used in the small scale, when we talk about our grains at our home. Okay, then sometime some tablets are there which is kept along with the grains. Now this tablet also, it contains certain chemicals which doesn't allow the we should say our rodents and insects and bacteria and fungi, and even, you know, insects, small insects which are very ready to attack the grains. So it also prevents this kind of insects. So what are these two methods? Like first I told, the at homes neem leaves are kept, and second, certain kind of tablets are also used to remove, to keep all these insects away from the grains. Now if you remember, if you have seen tamarind, we usually keep tamarind also at home. So it has to, like how it has to be kept, it is added, like some salt is added, some salt is added to that. So when some salt is added, again what happened, the moisture is absorbed from that, okay, and then again when moisture is not there, again it can prevent the that particular food from being attacked by the different kind of insects. Okay, so what are the ways, how can the grains can be prevented? The grains can be prevented by drying, by keeping the neem leaves, by also by using certain kind of chemicals, by using the process of fumigation, and also by keeping the place very, very clean. Okay, now all these measures has been taken, but now where the crop has to be stored? Okay, where the crop has to be stored? When we talk about storing, the crops can be stored in two ways. Okay, it can be a dry storing and it can be a cold storing. That means, you know, I'm talking particularly about the temperature. Just now we have studied about the dry places, like the places has to be very, very dry, the moisture should not be there. But for different food grains, for different kind of food, for different kind of articles, we need to have different kinds of method for proper storage. So where it can be, the where the food has to be stored, okay? The food can be stored in different godowns at the like what is godown? A vast, a big room which is like what we have just read. It is clean, it is fumigated, it is it had a spray of how to say the chemicals, okay? So that room is godown. Which room? Which is totally prepared, okay? It is prepared to keep the crops over there. A room which is very safe for the crops, okay? A room which is very very like which keeps the insects and rodents, all this away from the crops. And see, now in the rooms also there should be something in which the grains has to be stored. So what that something can be? It can be silos. Now what do you mean by silos? It is a big tall cylindrical container, okay? For storing, see, the when we talk about farmers, it is obviously a commercial level, okay? When the grains are being when the grains has to be stored on the commercial level, so the containers can't be very small. It will be just waste of time and the place to store the grains in the very small boxes. So what is silos? It is a very tall cylindrical structure for the storage of the grains. What is silos? It is tall cylindrical and like cylindrical structure for the storage of the grain. And you know, one very special quality of silos. See, these silos are made up of metals, okay? These silos are made up of metals, and these silos have different openings. See, like this is silo, just a rough this thing. It will have a different openings. That means because of this different openings means it will have multiple openings. So say suppose 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So if a particular amount of grain is required, okay, if a particular amount of grain is required, so this part can be opened and can be the grain can be removed. Again, if more is required, again this part can be opened and removed, okay. So what is the use of this? Why this so many openings are given in the silos? For the very simple reason that if the whole amount of this container is opened, okay, and from this container if small amount of grains are removed, okay, then again if it is closed and kept, what will happen? The grain which is left down will again have a chance of being attacked by the again the bacteria and the fungi, okay? So to prevent this kind of danger, what is being done? Silos are being made. Which what is silos? It is very tall, it is cylindrical, it is made up of metals, and it has got various like many or at least few particular different openings at different level. What is the use of this different opening? A particular amount of grains can be removed from these silos without opening the total container, okay? Now what happens when total container, the full complete container is not open? The whole grain doesn't comes and in the contact of the air, okay? Now if the farmers has to open this and they have to remove a particular amount of grain for this, okay? And if the farmer is doing this in the rainy season, just imagine द एयर हैज गॉट मॉइस्चर, है ना, आई शुड से ह्यूमिडिटी, द एयर हैज गॉट ह्यूमिडिटी एंड दिस ह्यूमिडिटी विल बी अगेन क्वाइट इनफ फॉर द लिविंग बींग्स लाइक बैक्टीरियाज एंड फंगाई टू कम एंड अटैक. सो वॉट हैज टू बी डन, द होल पार्ट इज kept safe. How? Without opening it, it is kept closed only, and whatever particular amount of grain has to be removed, it is that particular latch is opened. Suppose this much amount of grain is required, this both will be opened. Only if this much is required, then only this much part is open and the grains can be removed. Okay, now one more kind of storage is there, which is known as cold storage. Okay, what it is known as? It is known as cold storage. Now, what is this cold storage and what things are kept under this kind of storage? So, cold storage, as the name itself suggests, the temperature has to be low. Temperature is low. Okay. Now, what are the things which need to be kept on the low temperature? So, what are the things which can be kept on the low temperature? Maybe flowers, maybe fruits, okay, maybe milk products, okay. See, in spite of doing rectification, just try to relate this thing, everything, you know, whatever we read, always try to relate the things. Now, when we talk about cold storage, just remember, just open the fridge, okay. What are the things which is kept in the fridge? Obviously, fruits are kept. I have written fruits. What else is kept? Vegetables are kept. See, I have not written vegetables. I can write here vegetables. Okay. Fruits and vegetables. Yes or no? A very good method. So, what are the things which has to be kept on the low temperature? We were there in the, we were seeing the fridge. Okay. So, what is there in the fridge? Fruits are there, we have written over here fruits. Vegetables are there, we have written vegetables. Milk products are there, maybe take the example of butter, we have kept the butter, we have kept the cheese, okay. So, all these things are there, maybe sauces are there, different type of sauces are there, okay. Now, flowers we usually don't keep in the fridge, but all these kind of food material is kept in the cold storage. Or, you know, one more thing what we can write over here, the food item which has the food item which has very less life. Okay. See, we cannot store cheese as much as we can store wheat, definitely. We cannot store fruit as much as we can store rice. So, what are the things which we can keep in the cold storage? All the things which we can keep in the refrigerator, and the things which has low life, which can't be kept for a very, very long period. So, all these things can be kept in the cold storage. Okay, now this, what is the use of storing the things? Okay, why we have to store the things? Why storing is very, very important? Okay, see, there are certain things because of which we need to store the food and we need to keep the food. So we will just try to have a look on the advantages of the storage, why the storing has to be done. Okay, just I will draw a line over here so that it can make a clear demarcation Okay, so now we are going to read about advantages advantages of storage. Why should we store the food? Or I always tell that whenever I am saying we means I am talking in general. Okay, so why the food has to be stored? What are the advantages of storing the food? So first of all, see, take example from your home itself. Why do we keep the milk in the fridge? Why do we keep the cheese and butter in the fridge? First answer is to prevent it from the spoilage, to prevent it from it, like it shouldn't get spoiled. Okay, so I will write over here the same point, to prevent, or just to increase the storing life, hai na, to prevent the food items. Okay, why we are storing it at home? To prevent, hai na, to keep it safely. Okay, so to prevent the food items, and what can be the other thing? To increase the storage period. Okay, to increase the storage period means what? See, if you are not storing the food properly, commercially also, if the food is not stored properly, obviously it is going to get spoiled. And you know one thing, in our country 19%, just a very big amount for the country like us, which is known as agriculture country, which we all know the amount of the number of the people who don't get food is very large, is very high. So in like the country like ours, 19% of food is being wasted just because of the careless storage this thing, storage, like the storage, storing is not proper, the ways of the storage are not proper. So it's just a waste of efforts, money, time, and you know the poor ones, the ones who are not getting the food to eat, and so much of food is being just wasted and spoiled. So rather a great attention is required to store the food properly. Okay, so what I'm telling related, why do we store the food at home? So to prevent the food items, obviously we need the food items to be prevented. Okay, so we have to keep the things in the fridge, or we do certain extra things, like we keep the wheat in the sun, we keep the neem leaves, we keep the certain tablets, okay, to increase the storage period. Same thing, we have to increase the storage period. Okay, if we keep it for very if we don't store it properly, the storage period will decrease, it will get spoiled, and we'll have to throw it. Okay, now what can be the next point? The availability of food in all seasons. Okay, now what is the meaning of availability? Okay, now availability means what? It is available for us, we have that, we can get that. Okay, we know that particular whatever thing you talk about, maybe certain we talk about fruit, maybe you talk about wheat, anything. So everything has a particular season. Okay, every crop, every fruit can't be grown randomly. Okay, so if it can't be grown randomly, so how it can be made available every time? No, so just to make the things available in all the seasons, okay, in all the seasons we can have wheat, means we can keep it with us. How can we keep it with us? by keeping it, by storing it in the proper way. Okay, so if we store the things properly, we can use it in all the seasons. Even though the food is, the crops won't be harvested every now and then, it won't be there in the fields, but it is there with us, it is there in the market. How? Just because the proper storing methods. Okay, and just take the example of a particular fruit, mango. Okay, in general we cannot get mangoes in all the seasons, but when you go to big cities like Mumbai, you will be getting mangoes in certain off season also. Okay, why it is possible? Just because they are using proper methods to store the food items, and that is the reason the mango is available in certain off season also. When you won't be getting it in market, when you won't be seeing it in the on the trees, but you will be finding it in some places. Okay, so what is the thing? The availability of food in all season. For this also the food can be stored. Now, you know, to meet with emergency situation, in the country. Okay, to meet with the emergency situation in the country, we all know this, we all understand this very properly. Maybe earthquakes, maybe due to floods, maybe failure of the crops, any kind of emergency, any kind of mishappening in the country, in the world, in the neighboring countries. Like if we have stock, we can depend upon that stock, and we don't have to we would be in a comfortable position, like yeah, we have that particular stock. How to relate this with our normal situation with us? How to remember this point? See, if we have only half kg of wheat, or say 1 kg of wheat, which is quite sufficient for a day, okay, or say we have 5-10 kgs of wheat, but why sometimes, like why we store wheat in emergency, why do we have lot amount of flour or different kind of things at home? Because any guest can come without without giving any kind of information, without informing us. If the guest comes and we don't have the things, okay, so even this can be related to that, and we can keep this thing in mind that to meet with emergency situations in the country, okay, this grain which is stored, the grain which is the stored grain in the emergency condition, the stored grains act as a buffer. It act as a buffer means it is there, we have with us. Okay, so the situation, whatever situation is there, maybe the floods are there, maybe drought is there, it can be well maintained. Okay, like well maintained means what? Well maintained, floods is maintained, not in that way. What is well maintained? That the distribution of food, okay, can be maintained, the food can be given to the particular needy people. Okay, now proceeding to the next point, it keeps a check, it keeps a check on the price of the food item in the market. Now, what is the meaning of this? It keeps a check on the price of the food items in the market. How it is possible? You might have heard something about share market. You might have heard something about, you know, one more market is there, which is not equivalent to share market, but it is somewhat like that only. It is known as commodity market. Okay, somewhat like share market. So you know, if the storing thing is there, the storage is there. Okay, so what is there? Like the rates doesn't moves very up and down. Okay, the rates are stable in the market. You might have observed, you might have seen somewhere, you might have seen in some movies also, you know, always I give examples of old movies. If you see some old movies, in that also, you know, certain jamidars or some kind of people, they are shown, like it is, the scenes are shown in this way, that they have stored lot amount of grains in the godowns, and what they show to the public, that they don't have grains. The grains are not made available in the market, and then what is done, what is being done, the rate of the grains are increased. And see, when we don't have and we want, so what is being done, we have to purchase in black. Okay, to explain you better, when you go for a movie and tickets are not available, okay, you just try to find out if somebody is there selling the tickets in the black, you know. So what is this? The same only, like tickets are not available on the windows, tickets are over, it is not there only, but there is someone who is selling the ticket, but in the double cost. Okay, but still the person who wants to go and watch the movie will, what he will do, he will purchase a ticket and the black, and is going to go and watch the, enjoy the movie. Same is the case here. If the food item is stored, okay, the storing, I'm talking about the government. Okay, government stores the food and keep it in the government godowns. So whenever emergencies are there, this items are allowed to come into the market and it is made available for the people. Okay, if the government doesn't stores the food, and if some other person stores the food, what will happen? Again the same thing, the prices will be high, and it will, like the people will be forced to buy that particular grain. Okay, so hope this point is clear. To keep a check on the price of the food items in the market, okay, it really plays a very important role. The storing plays a very, very important role to keep a check on the price. Okay, now what can be the next point? Like when we talk about suppose a crop, a fruit, take example of the apple, which is very well grown in Kashmir. Okay, the a particular fruit which is like say oranges, very well grown in the Nagpur, onions and grapes, well known of Nasik. Okay, so when like the one food item can't be grown in every place. Okay, why? Because we have read this, different crops need different kind of conditions, different crops need different kind of environmental conditions. Maybe in course of temperature, maybe moisture, maybe the climate. Okay, so when a crop is grown in a particular area, need to be brought up in the another areas of the country or the world. So how it can be done? It has to be transported, hai na? So what is the case? If the things are stored properly, then what will happen? It makes the transportation of food material easy. It makes the transportation of the food It makes the transportation of the food easy. If the food is not stored properly, okay, and it has to be brought from one area to another area, what will happen? It is going to get rotten, it is going to get attacked by the fungus. Maybe bacteria, I have not written over here now. Maybe bacteria, maybe some other insects on the way only. Okay, for transporting the food item from one place to another, the storing has to be done very properly, the packaging has to be done very properly. Okay, so just we'll have a look why the food items need to be stored. Why do we need to store the food items? And I told you before also that we are going to link it with our own conditions. Okay, why do we need to store the things? Why do we need to keep extra things with us? Okay, so simple reason, to make the, to prevent the food items, because we don't want our food items to get spoiled. That is the reason we keep the milk in the fridge, we keep the cheese, the butter, the fruits, vegetables in the fridge. We don't want the grains which we have purchased to get spoiled. Okay, you might have seen small black brownish color insect which often, you know, get automatically you can find them in your wheat or grains. If it is not stored in a proper conditions, if the grains are wet, the grains are not, you know, if the grains, they themselves is moisture is present inside the grains. So what will happen? You will keep on finding certain kind of germs or the pests into that. Okay. So to increase the storage of the, like the storage period of the food, we need to store the food. Okay. Now, why do we want to store? Because we want to make it available every time. Okay. So, in the same way, when we talk commercially, to the availability of food in all season, like the food can be made available in all the seasons. Okay. Now, then what is there? To meet with the emergency situations in the country, as I told, emergency at the home, like many guests have come at your home without informing you and you don't have milk at home. How do you make the tea? Okay, so just to meet the emergency situations in the country, maybe floods, maybe drought, okay, maybe earthquake. So to meet with all this situation, the storing of grains has to be done. Okay, now what can be the next one? The next one can be to keep a check on the price. It should not, the price should not increase, okay, unnaturally. What can be the next thing? It is, it makes the transportation of the food easy. Okay, so it makes the transportation of food easy, as the tea, it's more available in the Darjeeling and such kind of hilly places. So then what will happen? Only those people will be able to drink tea. We won't be getting tea easily. So then what has to be done? It is transported from there to every part of the country so that everybody can enjoy tea. Okay. So this is also very, very important. It makes the transportation of the food easy. Okay. So these are the points. Why do we need to store the food? Now we will move to the next topic, which is food from the animals. Now we are going to talk something about animal husbandry. Okay, our last topic, animal husbandry. Now, what is the meaning of animal husbandry? See, animals means animals, and husbandry means to take care. Okay, to take care in different ways. Now, what can be the ways? And first of all, why do we need to take care of animals? What is the need? So, just to bring this in notice, when we started this topic, I told you that the major sources of food, okay, so where do we get food? Sources of food, okay. If you remember, we spoke about this thing that we get food from plants as well as from animals. Okay, so these are the two major sources from where we get food. Now we have discussed much about the plants. Okay, we have discussed a lot of things, how the crops are grown, what is crop, what is agriculture, which kind of instruments has to be used. Okay, all these things we have read in detail. So now what is left now? To talk about animals, sources of animals are left. That means we even use animals, or the food which we get from the animals is also a very, very, plays an important role in our life, because from the animals also we get plenty of things like milk, honey, eggs, flesh, meat, okay, many things, and these are the things which we use for eating. There are many other things which is used commercially, like silk, like leather, okay, like wool. So these are the things which is used commercially, okay, these all things have commercial importance. So when animals play such an important role in our lives, we just can't ignore them, we just can't ignore them, okay. So what is animal husbandry? To write the definition, keeping of animals, okay, what I am writing, keeping of animals for some specific, for some specific purpose is known as animal husbandry. Okay, now keeping of animals for some specific purpose is known as animal husbandry. Now what can be this specific purpose? See, specific purpose may be to get wool, maybe to get egg, okay, maybe to get honey, all these, and all these things. Different animals are domesticated for different kind of products, okay. So what animal husbandry actually means? Feeding, caring, okay, feeding, caring of the animals, okay, feeding and caring of the animals in a particular way, okay, in a particular way means what? In a profitable way is known as animal husbandry. We will not discuss this topic in detail over here. We may read this chapter in this topic in some other chapter, but just you know, what are the animals, which animals are kept? So just honeybees, okay, then goats, cows, buffaloes, camels, okay, fishes, okay, and silkworms, all these are very, very useful and is kept under different conditions, okay, different conditions means what? Favorable conditions. It is very, very essential to make these animals comfortable. It is very, very essential to check the feeding of these animals proper nutrition has to be given, okay. And say for example, take the example of hens, okay. So different qualities of hens are there. Some are broilers and some are layers. That means the one which is used for the flesh, the chicken, the flesh, okay. And the other which is responsible, whose eggs are being used. So different kind of animals are kept in comfortable conditions. Their cleaning has to be taken care of. Their bathing has to be taken care of. Then their food, what they eat, okay, it has to be taken care of. Their urination, their all waste has to be cleaned nicely. The proper place has to be there. Ventilation has to be proper. The vessels in which they eat need to be cleaned up properly. Okay, so this all has to be done time to time, and all these comes under animal husbandry. Okay, so this was about our animal husbandry, the last topic of the chapter. Thank you.